Welcome to Outreach Marufu TV. Thank you so much for joining me as we get into a new topic in this new season. We are taking a short break from bringing you new content because we're working on something. And thank you so much for your patience. Thank you so much for always being there. And don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to our channel. So this week I'll be talking about dreams. Dreams and visions, not the dreams that you dream while you are sleeping, but I'm talking about ideas, goals, plans, visions, and things that you desire to be in life. If you check in history, most men that we now see and appreciate as great men, they were men of dreams, they were men of visions. The richest king ever to live was the King Solomon, son of David. The man was a serious dreamer. It all started with a dream that he had after sacrificing 1,000 offerings on the mountains. And after sacrificing in Jerusalem, he saw the manifestation of his dream. The dream came from a supernatural God, and he began to pursue the dream, and it is the dream that made him to be who he is. So you yourself, before you can be anything, make sure you are a dreamer. And the first lesson that I learned the time I joined the Christian faith was the lesson that there are no laws against dreaming. You can dream as big as you want. You can go as far as you want in regards to dreaming and in regards to having visions. I'm not just talking about the dream that you have while you're sleeping or the dream that comes as you are praying and God begins to speak to you. I'm talking about your desires, the desired outcome that you have in life, the one that you want to see, the person that you see yourself as in the next maybe 1 hour, in the next 1 month, in the next 1 year, or even in the next 10 years. That is the dream that I'm talking about today. So, the dream that you have is also the limit of your blessing. As far as you can dream, that's as far as God can give you. Genesis 13, when God was speaking to Abraham, he was telling him, as far as your eyes can see, that is what I will give you. Which means the boundary of his blessing and the boundary of the manifestation of that which he wanted to see was actually determined by the sight that he had, the things that he was seeing, the dreams that he was having. Jeremiah chapter number 1, I believe is verse number 10. Jeremiah was told by God, he says, "See, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms, to root out and to pull down and to destroy and to throw down, to build and to plant." Before he can plant, before he can root, God had to say to him, but he had to tell him to see it happening. He said, "See, I have this day set thee over nations." If you could not see it, you could not have it. What you don't see, you don't seize in life. It is what you see that you seize. So as far as your eyes can see Abraham, I'm talking to an Abraham of today. As far as your eyes can see, God is saying to you now, that is only as far as I can give to you. So if your limit, let's say financially is 1,000, you can only see yourself having 1,000. That's the limit of your blessing. And God cannot give you beyond your vision and cannot give you beyond your dreams. It will take mercy, it will take God's grace for you to see beyond what you have seen. So I want to encourage you, brothers and sisters, listen to this word. There are no laws against dreaming. You can dream as far as you want to go. Who knows? You might be the next president. Who knows? You might be the next prime minister. And you might be asking, me being a president, you have actually placed a law against your dream. You see, no one was arrested for dreaming. Even if it doesn't come to pass, who will come to arrest you for dreaming? Keep on dreaming and keep pursuing your dreams. I am continuing with this message and I am continuing on this topic, helping you and guiding you on how we can come to the place of actualization, to the place of realization, to the place of manifestation, so that we can see our dreams coming alive. Did you know the prophet Habakkuk, I believe, is chapter 2, verse number 2. It is the vision that he saw that produced speed. It is the vision that he saw that produced speed. He said, "Write the vision on tables, that he may run that readeth it." Make it plain. So the day you have the vision, that is the day speed is introduced in your life. People without dreams, people without visions, they don't have speed in life. I'll come with that topic again of speed. How you can actually activate the graceful speed in your life through dreams and through visions. The Holy Ghost being the facilitator of both the dreams and the visions. He can actually work through you, desire through you. And that desire that you have is a desire ordained by God. And it can actually be the voice of God, because the Bible says you now have the mind of Christ. He says, acknowledge the Lord in all that you do. He says, love the Lord in all that you do. Acknowledge Him, delight in Him, and He'll give you the desires of your heart. Those are not just the desires of your heart. You cannot align to the Lord and your desires be away from the desires of God. It is now God delighting and desiring things through you. Through you. Some of you, you can attest to this. Before you even joined the Christian faith, or before you even met certain people, you never had great desire. But they were imparted as you continued fellowship with certain individuals and personalities. And one of those personalities might be God. As you were praying, fasting, getting into the Word of God, fellowship, you started seeing bigger, better, bigger, better. What you now need to do is just to believe in the vision. Because as far as your eyes can see, it is only the limit of your vision that limits your blessing. And it is the abundance of your vision that brings abundance of blessing. God only supplies as far as your mind can reach, as far as your eyes can see, as far as you can think, as far as you can dream. He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or what or think. Which means your thinking capacity also determines how you are going to pray. And your thinking capacity is also going to determine the answers that you are going to get. And he actually says, according to the power that worketh within us. It might not only be the power of the Holy Ghost. It can also be the power of the vision that is working within you, that actually pushes you forward to take steps towards that dream, that goal, that vision. Always remember, there are no laws against dreaming. There are no laws against asking. A life without questions can never receive answers. You get into a castle, there is a car that you like. It is your goal. It is your desire. It is an idea. It is a dream. It is a vision. You are not arrested for asking for the prize. You are not arrested for fellowshipping with it. You are not arrested for getting into certain environments. You are not arrested. Of course, there are places where they say admission is reserved. But there are places that you want to frequent. You want to be part of that group. You want to be part of that cliche. You want to be part of that class. You are not arrested. You will not be arrested for pursuing such a goal. Because there are no laws, I repeat, against dreaming. You can close your eyes and begin to see yourself in the next 5 minutes, in the next 5 hours, in the next 5 months, in the next 5 years, the one that you want to be. And you realize the dream is possible, because God will not allow you to dream the dream without even giving you the power to see the dream coming to pass. We are going to take a very short break, and I'm bringing you part two and another topic in the same series of dreams and vision. I love you so much, and digest on this way.